How could someone at home, without having to take this to a laboratory and have come back with test results that this is this many milligrams, if I started with 7 grams of flour, I had 1 cup oil or butter, maybe I rinsed it, now I have 1.5 cups of it. Is there a way where I can at least get a ballpark, plus minus just a little bit, of how potent my recipe is about to be?
So we take flour that we know how strong it is, that we bought from our dispensary or whatever, and we know it's 10% THC. So that means that every gram of cannabis has 100 milligrams of THC, but it's THCA. And so we have a total of 700 milligrams of THCA in our entire project, right?
That's 100 times 7. Okay.
Yep. 100 times 7. However, when you decarboxylate, you're going to lose a little just because of some of it leaving through the heat. But more importantly, when you decarboxylate something, that carboxyl group, so decarboxyl, decarboxylate, that means you're taking off the carboxyl group from the chemical, which is, it converts to CO2 when it leaves, but it also takes weight with it. And so what you're left with is THC rather than THCA, and THC is 87.5% as heavy as THCA. And so when you have, you had 700 milligrams of THCA, but after you decarboxylate it, you're down to 612.5 milligrams that you can possibly extract out of your weed. So let's say you follow my guideline and you do the rinse. So you're not going to have to worry about this. But if you don't do the rinse, you're going to have to calculate how much that oil weighs and then subtract out the weight of oil that you lost. Let's say you're using 8 ounces of butter. Let's remember that 612.5. So 8 ounces of butter weighs about 200 grams because oil is lighter than water by about a factor of 90%. And so we're going to say that you put 200 grams of either oil or butter into your 700 gram or into your 7 grams of weed. So the total volume or the total mass, excuse me, of your whole pot of deliciousness is 207 grams. And then at the end, you weigh your oil after you filter it out and you only got 180 grams, let's say, because some stuck to the material and there's some stuck to the pan. And so you lost some. However, when you do your final calculation, you have to account for all of that because it's all the same concentration. And so even though you have 180 grams, you have to do your calculation based on 207. Does that make sense?
Yes.
So in your 207 grams, so 612.5 divided by 207. So your total concentration is 2.95 or 2.96 milligrams per gram of oil. Right. And then you multiply that by 180, which is what you got left over. And so you got 532 milligrams in your whole shebang. That said, if you do that rinse, you're going to capture more of that. And you can say with, you know, relative certainty, like then you just say, okay, I lost some of it, but you got most of it. But in the case where you don't rinse, you're definitely going to be with like 532 milligrams in your whole project. And then you divide that by what you got, which is 532 divided by 180. Your overall concentration is 2.95 milligrams per gram. And so if you use a teaspoon of oil in, like, let's say you spread a teaspoon, which weighs about 5 grams, on a piece of toast, then that's a 15 milligram piece of toast. And you're high. You're quite high.
And as Katie just explained, this is how the novices sometimes end up with their story because they eat a, I mean, 15 milligrams on a piece of toast is enough to put some people down.
Yeah. Cause you think you're looking at a teaspoon, like I could do a teaspoon or whatever, you know, yeah. Or a tablespoon. Yeah. Yeah. I got this. And then, you put it in your coffee or you put it on the toast. Yeah. That's, wow, actually, I have never, Katie, had anyone explain to me the breakdown of that way. Even on Google, I don't think you can Google that. Thank you very much. That was very good.
Yeah, this is my jam. So, And the thing is, the people think like, oh, and I literally did this, and I held the girl's hair back as she puked during our choir concert because she made a quarter ounce of weed into a pan of brownies and then had a brownie, which was like, you know, a ninth of the pan. And so, I mean, we're talking about probably, you know, what were we, like 512 milligrams divided by 9. And so she had like 57 milligrams, which,
wow.
Damn, no. No wonder wow. She was miserable.
No.
That's a rough
what's
one.
The short answer? Now, curious, what's the short answer?
The short answer is you multiply it by like 0.7, which is a really cheap and dirty way to say you're going to lose some. And so 700 times 0.7, it's like 20 milligrams off in the whole batch.
Wow. That's 490. Wow.
Yeah.
Cool.
Because that takes account for loss. It takes account for the decarboxylation. So that's like 13-ish%. And then, you know, we figure you're not in a lab environment. Like we get like a 95% minus the decarboxylation. We get a 95% extraction efficiency in our lab, but like, our lab is very anal retentive. So
that's what's up. So if it's 3 grams of THC per gram of oil, then
yeah.
If you use a quarter cup of oil, you're just taking that whatever that final weight was for that quarter cup times 3, and then depending on how many pieces you get out of that, you can then divide that into how many pieces that you got, and you can have an accurate amount of this brownie. Typically is 20 milligrams or 25 milligrams. Wow.
Yeah, you can ballpark it, you know. And for people who are sensitive to like by the milligram, like I am, like I'm never eating a homemade edible ever again because you know the variance is like 5 milligrams, right? And like that's enough to make me completely freak out. Like I like a 2 milligram dose, you know. So no one's ever gonna get close enough for me.
Yeah, I've been weird. Like I never like people, you know, you go to festivals and stuff and there's always some people selling some edibles on the side, whatever, in our cooler. I'm like, man, I how do you know what's in that thing? Like, you know,
you do not. Yeah. You do not. And it's like you kind of look at the dude and you see how high he is, and you kind of can guess that, like, and then they always say like there's an ounce in this batch. They always say that. And sometimes I believe them based on how high that dude is and how much to eat to stay that high all the time through the entire festival.
Love it. Love it. Thank you, Katie, for helping us calculate that. And of course, if you miss some of that or if you got lost in the math, there's always going to be a recording of this and you can just keep rewinding. And we may even put some images up on the final version of this to help kind of follow along. Because that is one of the top questions of how do you, you know, dose what you're making, especially when you're making it from scratch at home. So that's what's up. Yeah. We have our different cannabis therapy videos. If you click on the video, click on the attachment slide to get the free resource that's attached to that session. One of the key things about this hub is that you're able to search any type of keyword. If I type the word license, it will take you to what videos actually talked about licensing. And it will talk about also exactly where in that video it will actually talk about licensing. See you in the next video.